All Academy. Always with you.
Hello, my dear students. Welcome to this online video lecture on fluid mechanics. So in the previous session, we have discussed the very important topic on the Pascal law as well as hydrostatic law. And even we have derived the proof for these two laws. And in today's session, we'll go into solve the numericals on this Pascal law as well as the hydrostatic law. So without wasting much time, let us begin with today's session. So before going to solve the numericals, let us know what are the formulas required for this one. So one is a general formula that is, we all know, that is P is equals to rho g h. So this is a general equations used to identify the pressure, where rho is in a density and g is a gravitational constant and h is in a head. And another equation in a generalized form, I can write P is equals to force by area. Force by area is also used, where P is equals to pressure, F is in a force, and A is the area of that where the force is applied. And another equation is, we requires the area, that is A is equals to pi by 4 into d square for cylindrical. And if the another type of means whichever the shape of substance is there, based on that the area has to be calculated. This is the area. Okay, so these are the three important formulas that we see across while solving the numericals on the hydrostatic law as well as the Pascal law. So let us move to the first problem. The first problem statement says that a barometric reading at a place is 755 mm of Hg. Find the intensity of pressure 12 newton per centimeter square in terms of meter of water, meter of Hg, and kilonewton per meter square absolute pressure. Now this is a first question. So he says that there is a barometer, okay, which shows some reading at this place. Okay, it is showing some reading at 755 mm of Hg, and that pressure is having 12 newton per centimeter square. So let us note down the, and we need to identify the head in terms of water, then the head in terms of Hg, and we need to identify the absolute pressure. These things to be identified. Now before that, let us write down the given data in this one. So here the H is given, that is a 755 mm of Hg. So let us convert that into meters. So then it divided by 1000, so it becomes 0.7555 meter of Hg. Okay. And similarly, the pressure is given, that is P is given, that is 12 newton per centimeter square. If I convert that into meters, so then it becomes 12 into 10 raised to 4 newton per meter square. Newton per meter square. Okay. Now, first thing is we need to calculate this in terms of mm of water. Now, for that one, that is the first thing. So we need to use general equation, that is P is equals to rho g h. So since it is a water, he said, so the density we should take it as a water. What is the pressure intensity is already given, that is 12 into 10 raised to 4. That will be equals to 1000 into g is a 9.81 gravitational constant into hw we need to identify. So that is a head in terms of mm of water, meter of water, that we need to identify. Now hw will be equals to, now can you simplify and calculate this answer for in terms, the whatever answer you will get it, that will be in meters of water, just 12 into 10 raised to 4 divided by 1000 into 9.81. so just simplify me and let me know the answer in the comment section. So similarly, the next thing is the second. So here you need to get the answer in terms of mm of Hg. So Hg means the mercury here is there. So the density of mercury has to be considered. We have to use the same equation, that is P is equals to rho gh. Okay, P equals to rho gh. Now that is 12 into 10 raised to 4. That will be equals to, instead of 1000, so I have to use the density of mercury into 9.81 into Hg I will consider. Okay, Hg. Now if you simplify this one, Hg will be equals to, that you will get it in meters of mercury. So just 12 into 10 raised to 4 divided by 13,600 into 9.81. So if you divide it, you will get an answer that is in terms of mm of Hg. Even this has to be calculated, and let me know in the comment section. Now, so we have done with these two. So now the next is very important. We need to get the kilonewton per meter square of absolute. So we need to identify the absolute pressure now. So for this one, whatever the pressure he has given, so this is a pressure that is 12 into 10 raised to 4 newton per centimeter square is there. No, it is nothing but it is a gauge pressure. Now I need to identify the atmospheric pressure. So the absolute pressure is nothing but P atmosphere plus P gauge pressure. So this is the absolute pressure equation. Absolute pressure will be equal to sum of gauge pressure and the atmospheric pressure. Now first we need to identify the atmospheric pressure now. Now atmospheric pressure is equals to rho g h. So in this one, the h has to be taken this, okay, which is a given. And since this h is considered, means I have to take the density as in a mercury. So now p atmospheric will be equals to, that is 13,600 into 9.81 into, that is 0.755. Now p atmospheric you will get it, so that is 100.73 into 10 raised to 3 newton per meter square. Now if I want to convert this into kilonewton, means divided by 1000, so this will get cancelled, so it is directly 10.73 kilonewton per meter square. So now this is our atmospheric pressure. Now the P absolute, is equals to, already I have written the formula, P absolute is equals to P atmospheric plus P gauge pressure. Now P absolute will be equals to, what is atmospheric pressure we have calculated, that is 10.73 into 10 raised to 3, because this is in a newton per meter square, so I have to take it in a newton per meter square itself, plus 12 into 10 raised to 4 newton per meter square. Both the units are in a newton per meter square, so please calculate this one. So what is the answer you are getting? So that will be in a newton per meter square. The final answer, whatever you are getting, so that will be in a newton per meter square. You just calculate me and let me know the absolute pressure in the comment section. So hope you have understood this one. So why I have taken this as a so for gauge atmospheric pressure, means so I have to take the, what is a measured value, so that is the atmospheric pressure. Due to that, whatever h I have considered with respect to that h, what is our fluid is given, that has to be considered while calculating the atmospheric pressure. Now absolute pressure is equals to sum of atmospheric pressure and the gauge pressure. So this has to be remembered. And this question is asked in the 2015 for 6 marks. It is asked for a 6 marks in 2015, and each carries 2 marks. So okay, each answers has carried a 2 marks. So for calculating the final answer. Okay, so let us move to the next numerical. The next problem statement is, a hydraulic press has a ram of 30 cm diameter and a plunger of 4.5 cm diameter. Find the weight lifted by the hydraulic press when the force applied at a plunger is 500 newton. Now in this condition, for this I have taken a reference figure for your convenience. Now he says that there is a hydraulic press, and which is having a diameter. So this diameter is given, that is 30 centimeter, and this diameter is given, that is 4.5 centimeter plunger it is given, and force is given, that is 500 newton. Okay, this is a given. Now I need to identify the, what is a weight. So I need to identify this, how much weight it is lifted when I apply the 500 force at the plunger side. So before solving this one, let us note down the given data. Now I will take this as in a capital D, that is 30 centimeter. If I convert that into meters, it becomes 0 meter. Now for the area I will calculate, this is, I will take in a capital A, that is pi by 4 into d square. Now area will be equals to, so you just substitute d square as 0.3. So we'll get an area that is around 0.7068 meter square, we will get it. Now similarly, small d, the plunger side P, so that is equals to how much, what is the diameter? It is having a 4.5 centimeter. If I convert that into meter, it becomes 0.045. Then a small area A will becomes around 0 point. So the same formula has to be used, that is pi by 4 into d square. So if you calculate it, 0.00159 meter square. Now this is an area. Now, so we know that the, I will write it. Now the pressure at plunger side, so that is given by the P, I will take it PP. P means pressure at plunger side. It is given by force by, so which area has to be considered here? The small area. So it is a A. Now that is, I will substitute, that is F is given 500 Newton divided by area, that is 0.00159. So if you simplify this, you will get a pressure at plunger side. So that will be around 314.65.4 Newton. Now this is a pressure at the plunger side. Okay. Now the similarly, the pressure, now the pressure at ram side. So this is a ram. So ram side. So I will write it, that is PR, I will take it. That is given by W. So here the area, I have to take it as a larger area, that is A. But I don't know what is the W. So this has to be calculated. But we know that from Pascal law, from the Pascal's law, we know that whatever the pressure we applied, it will be equal in all the direction in the static fluid. So that I can write it, that is pressure applied on the plunger side will be equals to pressure intensity at the ram side. So I will write it, that is 314.65.4 will be equals to W by, what is the area of in a larger or ram? It is a 0.07068. Now if you simplify this one, you will get a W. You will get a W in terms of Newton. So you find the, you calculate it, and let me know the what is the answer, or what is the weight lifted by this hydraulic press. So just simple calculation, just cross multiply these two, you will get a W. So let me know what is a W for this answer. So hope it is clear to you people. So let us move to the next type of problem. And the next problem statement is, an oil tank contains a water up to depth of 2 meter and above its oil is specific gravity 0.9 for a depth of 1 meter. Find the pressure intensity at an interference of 2 liquids and at the bottom of tank. Now this is a reference figure for the above stated problem. Now in this condition, what he says that, so there are 2 liquids in a container. So one is having a specific gravity of 0.9 and another one is a water which is at the bottom. Now I need to calculate, we need to calculate the pressure intensity at this point, that is point A, and the pressure intensity at the point B. Now the pressure on this point B is due to the oil as well as the water, because both are above this point. So that is a pressure intensity creating on this point B. Now when it comes to the point A, the only oil will be creating pressure on the point B, because the point B is just below the oil. So that we need to calculate the points, that is a pressure intensity as point A and point B. For that one, let us note down the given data. Now given, So the H1 is given, so that is 1 meter. H2 is given, that is 2 meter, and rho 1 is given, that is 0.9 into 1000, because this is have a specific gravity is given, so that has to be multiplied within a standard fluid. Then you will get a 900 kg per meter cube. Then rho 2 is a water, which is a standard one, that is 1000 kg per meter cube. Now at point A, now the pressure at point A. So at point A, only one oil is creating its pressure. So it is a PA is equals to rho G H. I will take it. So what is the density of this one? That is 900 into 9.81 into H. So what is H? It is a 1. Now PA will be equals to, it is a 8829 Newton per meter square. If you simplify this one, you will get the pressure of 8829 Newton per meter square. So this pressure, this much of pressure will be acting on the point A. Now at pressure, now the pressure at point B, now the pressure at point B is equals to, now at this condition, at pressure point B, both water and oil is creating the pressure on the point B. For that condition, so we need to consider both the oil, so that pressure B is equals to rho 1 G H1 plus rho 2 G H2. Because both the liquids are creating the pressure on this one. So this already we have calculated. Okay, that is PB is equals to rho 1 is a 900 into 9.81 into H1. H1 is how much? 1. Then plus it is a 1000 density of water into 9.81 into 2. Now if you simplify this one, will get an answer, that is in Newton per meter square. So let me know this answer, how much answer you will get it for this problem. So if you simplify these two equations, this completely, you will get an answer, that is a pressure at this point B. So let me know this answer in the comment section. So let us move to the next problem statement. In the next problem statement is, the diameter of a small piston and a large piston of a hydraulic jack are 3 cm and the 10 cm respectively. A force of 80 Newton is applied on the small piston. Find the load lifted by the large piston when. So there are two conditions he has given. So when the pistons are at the same level. And the second condition is, small piston is 40 cm above the large piston. Now in this problem statement, so there are two cases. So he says that, so there are a piston and a hydraulic jack, so which is having some diameter, that is a 30 cm and the 10 cm, and a force of 80 Newton is applied. He says that how much weight is lifted when both are at the same height. And in the second condition, he says that when the plunger is above 40 cm, what is the height or what is the weight lifted by this hydraulic jack, that we need to identify. So for your reference, I have drawn a first condition. Okay, this is a figure for case 1. This is for condition A. Now before that, let us note down the given data. Given that is a capital D is given, that is 10 cm is given. Okay, then a small d, I'll take it, d is equals to, it is 3 cm. Then force is given, it is 80 newton. Okay, so these are the given datas. Now the at case, for case A, when both are at the same height, and both are same height, now the I will calculate the area for this one, that is pi by 4 into capital D square. So you will get an answer of around 78.54 meter square. And similarly, small area, that is pi by 4 into d square, will be equal to, it is a 7.068 meter square. Now these are the areas with respect to diameter 10 cm and diameter 3 centimeter. Now the pressure at first condition, the pressure at plunger. So we'll take it as in a PP. Pressure at plunger at PP is equals to F divided by small area, because the force is how much? It is 80 Newton and it is applied to the smaller area. So that will be equals to 80 divided by area. Smaller area is 7.068. Now we will get an answer of 11.32 Newton per centimeter square, because this area I have calculated in a centimeters. Okay. This area I have calculated in a centimeters. So the answer I will get it in a centimeter square itself, Newton per centimeter square. But in the previous cases, I have converted all that units into meters. But this in this problem, I have taken in a centimeter square, so that you can be clear with both the type of problems when we need to convert newtons meters into centimeter. What will be the readings when I converts into in if I keep it in a centimeter itself? Okay. Now similarly, now the pressure. Now pressure at ram side. The pressure at ram side, that is, I will take it as an a PR. That will be equals to W by capital A. Now this is a pressure intensity to be identified for at a ram side. But from the Pascal law, we know that pressure intensity at P, that is plunger side, will be equals to pressure intensity at ram side. Because in the static fluid, when I apply pressure at any point, it will be equal in all the directions. That is a Pascal law. So based on this Pascal law, the pressure intensity at P will be at this side will be equal to the pressure intensity at ram side. Now, what I need to identify? I need to identify this W. I need to identify. Now, as based on the Pascal law, so I'll take 11.32. So based on the Pascal law, it is 11.32 will be equals to W divided by capital A, that is 78.54. Now, if you simplify this, you will get a W in Newton, Newton. If you simplify this one, you will get a weight lifted by this plunger when I apply 80 Newtons. So that W will need, just you cross multiply these two. If you cross multiply these two, you will get an a weight lifted at the ram side. Now this is the first case. Now let us move to the second case. Now this is a reference figure for your convenience. So it, as it says that the plunger is a 40 centimeter above. Here you can see this one, 40 centimeter above. Now the pressure at plunger will be equals to, one is pressure intensity, that is by the force applied, plus the force, or the it is a pressure due to this 40 centimeter rise. So these are the two forces. Now let us calculate the PP, that is nothing but force divided by small area. So that is how much force? 80, and area is 0.068, that is 11.32 you will get it. So 11.32 Newton per centimeter square. Now I need to calculate this pressure due to 40 mm rise. So that is calculated. So that is the pressure due to 40 centimeter rise, that is given by rho gh. This is a height. Now rho is a density, that is water, 9.81. Now this 40 centimeter height has to be, centimeter has to be converted into meters. This 40 centimeter has to be converted into meters, so then it will becomes 0.4 meters, because the density unit is in a meters. So I have to convert this in a meters, so that is 0.4. Now I will divide this whole term by 10 raised to 4 to make it into meters, or to make it into centimeter square, to make it, because the one answer I have kept in a centimeter square. So this answer I have kept in a centimeter square. So for first, we need to calculate this in a meters and divide it by 10 raised to 4, so that our P40 will becomes, so the P40 will becomes due to that 40 centimeter rise. So that we need to convert that into Newton per centimeter square. Now, if you simplify this one, you will get an answer of 0.37. 379 you will get it. 0.379 you will get the answer. Okay. So now the final answer, the pressure at plunger, that will be equals to 11.32 plus 0.379. So the final answer, you will get it around 11.71 Newton per centimeter square. Now this is a pressure intensity at plunger side. That is because of force as well as due to that rise in the 40 centimeter. Now the pressure intensity at ramp, that will be equals to, that is P R will be equals to W by capital A. So this W by capital A. Now I need to calculate this value, that W I need to calculate it. Now based on the Pascal law, so we can directly solve it. That is P R will be equals to PP. So PR will be equals to PP means it is 11.71 will be equals to W divided by capital A. So capital A answer, you know that. So capital answer is, just erase this thing. So that is 11.71 will be equals to W divided by 78.54. Now if you cross multiply these two, you will get a W. So that will be in a newtons. So please let me know what is a answer for this one in a comment section. So one we have solved it, one previous condition when both are at the same level we have solved it. In this condition it is 40 centimeter is above. So due to that 40 centimeter rise also, there will be some pressure intensity created in this section. That is, in this section there is some pressure intensity will be created. One pressure intensity is due to the force applied, and along with that the due to that height that we have calculated. One is due to this area, force and area, and another one is a due to this, the 40 centimeter rise. So in that condition, first you need to convert the centimeter into meter. After final answer you will get it, divide it by 10^4, because you have kept the previous answer in a Newton per centimeter square. Then add together, then you will get the pressure intensity. Then you will get the pressure intensity, that is pressure intensity at plunger side. This is a pressure intensity at plunger side. Now we know that PR is equals to PP, that is based on the Pascal's law, because it is a static fluid. So and the pressure applied at a point in any static, on a static fluid, will be equal in all the direction. So that, based on that condition, so we have an equation that is 11.71. This is a pressure at the plunger side will be equals to W divided by A. So A, W we need to identify. So this value, this condition, this value we have to identify. So that will be equals to, so that will be equals to 11.71 equals to W divided by 78.54. That is the area of capital area, this area of this ramp. So then if you cross multiply that one, you will get a W, that is weight lifted by this ramp or hydraulic jack. Okay, that you will get it in terms of Newton. So please let me know the answer for this one in a comment section. So hope, dear students, so whatever numericals we have solved in today's section, that is based on the Pascal law and hydrostatic law, hope it is clear to you people. Still if you are finding any difficulty in understanding these numericals, even I have solved more number of problems in my notes also. And these questions generally ask for 6 to 8 marks. And in the next session, we'll going to solve the numericals on the different types of manometers. And these are very important. If you cross check all the question papers, one question is definitely going to ask in the manometers, the numericals on the manometers. So if you are having any doubts on the problems, whatever we have solved today, you can just comment it in the comment box and we'll try to clarify your doubts.
Click on subscribe button and press the bell icon to get updates from All Academy.